Hey guys, I'm back with another video. This video is super important, so I hope that some of my advice can help at least a few of you, because I did get questions asking how to cope, not just with physical problems, but mental problems like dark thoughts, anxious thoughts, and things like that. So what I'm going to be sharing with you is what I use personally that works for me. If it doesn't work for you, then you might have to do some more research on different ways to cope. And I'm gonna put links in the description of different things that might help you. All right, so the number one thing that you must have is a crisis plan. This is a plan that you can either create on your own or with a therapist, psychiatrist, social worker, someone like that. This plan will have contacts of people you can talk to when you are feeling like you are spiraling or when you feel like you are in danger. It can also have treatment centers that you are willing to go to, your medications that you need to take, and very important information that you and your therapist can decide on, or you can decide on yourself. I'm gonna be leaving links in the description of examples of crisis plans and ways that you can make your own. If you do end up making one, just make sure that you share it with a therapist or someone who is very important to your treatment. The second thing that I'm gonna mention is something called HALT. So it stands for hungry, angry, lonely, and tired. And so if you're super hungry and you find yourself really irritable, find a snack to eat. If you're super tired, try to take a nap. I mean, it's self-explanatory. So if your issue just stops there, then you've done the work and hopefully you can start feeling better. Something that I really like to do is journaling, and I don't just journal like I went to the store today, I did this. I journal in a stream of consciousness. So I journal whatever my thoughts are in that moment that I'm journaling. And this is super important because this can help you get all these things off of your chest. It can help you feel more relieved, less stressed, and you can feel like maybe you even discover something about yourself that you did not already know. And that's super awesome when that happens. Another thing you can do is reach out to someone. So this can be a family member, a friend, a therapist, just someone that you trust. So the next two are kind of like distraction techniques. The first one would be to take a walk. This can help you clear your head. This can help you just, you know, focus on nature and relax. Another thing that you can do is to take a shower. This is something that I like to do, but I don't do it all the time. You kind of have to gauge how much energy you have. So if you know that if you take this shower, you won't have energy to do anything else the rest of the day, I would advise you to not take that shower because you do need to eat. You do need to take care of yourself, you know? So if you're not gonna have energy after a shower, please don't do it. I've done it before and then I'm like sitting in my towel and I'm like, now what? I have no energy to do anything else. Be mindful of your energy levels. Be mindful of if this will actually even help you in the end. Something else that's really helpful that I always do is I have a folder on my computer full of resources. And you can do this on your phone. You can print things out and put them in a folder that's tangible. You can do whatever is more comfortable. In my folder, I have different articles, I have some workbooks, and I have some documents that I created myself. So I have a document in this folder that is 100 things that are positive in my life. So you can try to start with just creating 10 things, then 20, then 30, and you'll find yourself actually being grateful and positive about a lot of things in your life, even something as simple as clean water or clean air. Another document that I have is activities that I can do. So these activities are things I know I can do when I'm feeling low, and this includes low energy as well. So in there, it could be like, I'll read a few pages of a book, I will pet my dog, things like that. And I started out with a goal of 100, and now I'm at 140 activities. So you'd be surprised how many things you can think of. Just remember that when you're creating any documents like this, to make sure that you're in a good emotional space to do it. That way you're not feeling low and trying to create these documents because you won't have a lot to put down when you're feeling those very low feelings or those dark thoughts. Another thing that really helps me cope mentally is to take care of something else. So this can be a fish, a dog, a plant, or even another person. Let's say your friend is going through like a breakup right now or something, or they are not doing well in a subject in school or something. If it helps you to help other people, you can try that. If you don't have the energy to do it, don't do it. I only do this sometimes, so like if someone has like a little dilemma that they need help with and I'm already feeling, you know, badly about myself, it helps distract me. But I don't choose things that are going to drain me, you know? I don't know why, but it just really helps me to think about other people's problems rather than my own. And I'm a lot better at helping other people than I am myself. So maybe you're like me and you can also try this. So now I'm going to move on to the physical aspect of it. So when you're physically feeling ill or down, these are some things that I found that help. Number one is to prepare ahead of time. Just like the mental health, you have to prepare for when you're going to be having a flare-up, when you're going to be having a bad day. So for me, what I do is I have meds by my bed and I keep them in a tiny pill box. That way it's just easy to grab, easy to store them. I also keep some snacks in my top drawer. So I have like some fruit snacks, some very plain crackers, just things that I know that I'll be able to eat when I'm feeling really badly. If you live with someone that helps take care of you, or if you have someone that comes over to help you out, like a friend or a family member, I like to make a schedule of what I need throughout the day. So I'll have like a medication schedule written out, and then you can even put like times that you need to eat if you're like me who has to eat at certain times. So you can do that. That way it's easier to explain to them, this is what I need, and it's just all on a nice piece of paper, rather than asking them, hey, can you get the bottle that looks like this with the pill that looks like that? It's gonna be too confusing for them, and it might just drain you even more. I like to get into very comfy clothes when I start feeling badly, so I have like a whole outfit plan. I have my fuzzy pajama pants, a nice big t-shirt, and some fuzzy socks. For you, it might be something completely different, and that's totally okay. Whatever makes you comfortable. Hopefully getting into comfy clothes makes you feel a little bit better too. I know when I wear them, it helps me relax better, because usually I just get into bed when that happens. So if you're gonna plan on like relaxing in bed or taking a nap, changing your clothes is very helpful. So once you're in your comfy clothes, if you're still feeling like anxious about the way you feel, or you just can't stop focusing on your pain or whatever the ailment is, you can try some meditation. This is like a hit or miss for me. I know some people, like, they swear by it. For me, I don't know, like, sometimes it doesn't work. I guess like sometimes it's really hard for me to focus on something like that. But meditation might help you. So if it's something that you want to try it a few times. Don't just try it once and give up. Try it a few times, find out which meditations work for you. If you just like to listen to relaxing music, that's cool too. Meditation helps me more when I do a breathing exercise with it. So like a breathing exercise that I do is I breathe in for 4 seconds, I hold it for 4 seconds, and I release it for 6 seconds, like a very long breath. That helps me relax and it helps me not focus on whatever I'm feeling. And I would say the number one most important thing if you're dealing with a physical health problem or flare up is to knock it off your schedule. Just don't do it. Do whatever you can to stay on your schedule, whether it's an eating schedule, medication schedule, your sleep schedule. Do whatever you can to keep your schedule as similar as possible to what you usually do. All right, so that's it for today's video. I hope that you guys learned something from this. Leave your comments below of what you like to do to help yourself cope and feel better. I hope that at least one of these things can help you in the future. And as always, if you guys have questions or suggestions for future videos, just leave them in the comments. I'll definitely be reading them. I hope you enjoyed our guest star today, Baby Yoda. You know that I love Star Wars, so he had to be here to support you guys. Thank you guys for watching, and please take care of yourselves and stay well. All right, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.